Good morning. Just waiting this last minute and reconnecting. Oh, and then I'm ready to go. Still can't play music, just so everybody knows. Today we're doing foam rolling and we're gonna use a ball too. Matt House has actually let me use his ball because it was left at the gym. So he told me I could look after it until he comes back from parental. So thank you, Matt. And I'm having a problem with just reconnecting. Good morning. I'm going to be sharing this afterwards too. Electronics technology. We'll see how quiet it stays in here today because my kids are upstairs taking care of themselves at this time. We'll see how that goes. Okay. Okay, I'm Trina Ford. I'm here. Hi guys. In Wainwright, PSP. I'm gonna get our disclaimer going. Today we're gonna be doing foam rolling. Foam rolling is a really important part. You also can use a ball if you choose. You can get different benefits from it for sure. I'm just going to start from our neck and then we're going to go all the way down the back of our body and then we're going to come back up from our toes all the way up the front of our body. I would recommend if you get a place where you're feeling like you want to stretch it out more to stay with me at this time. And then at the end, go back to those movements that you want to spend more time on and please do so. That way then you can actually feel your whole body. Plus also if we go through the whole body, sometimes we don't even realize we're sore in different areas until we do them, okay? I'm not going to be holding them for a very long period of time, but realistically, I would recommend for you to be able to spend more time on it or even at the end, go back and again, redo some of them that you felt muscle soreness. Once we are done this is like giving yourself a deep tissue massage. I want you to make sure you drink lots of water today. I want you to just stretch yourself out throughout the day and enjoy it. This here is all about reading your own body and feeling it. So I'm going to just play the disclaimer first and that way then we covered that part. Also, the disclaimer is put in the comments area too. I will not be able to play music. That doesn't mean that you can't play something nice. I would recommend something relaxing. Go even into one of your apps and put relaxing music. And that way then you can lay on it and really feel your body. Okay.
In response to COVID-19, PSP is offering virtual fitness to Canadian Armed Forces members. By using social media platforms, the virtual fitness classes tailored to Canadian Armed Forces personnel become accessible to all. Participants who are not Canadian Armed Forces members recognize and acknowledge that their age, health status, and physical fitness levels are unknown, and it is entirely up to each individual to assess their ability to participate in this class. Since it is preferable to consult your physician before beginning any exercise program, we invite all participants who are not Canadian Armed Forces members to consult the Get Active questionnaire of the Canadian Society of Exercise Physiology and its reference document. If you experience any pain or difficulty during the exercises presented in this video, it is recommended that you stop and consult a healthcare provider. If a CAF member sustains an injury during this video, please remember to fill out a CF98.
Thank you, Tracy, for doing that for us. From here, what I'm going to get you all to do is just find yourself somewhere comfortable. Grab your foam roller or your baseball. Or in this case, I'm actually using Madhouse's beautiful ball, too. What I'm going to get you to do is just laying down. There's different kinds. This one is the softer kind. This here is less aggressive. This is a harder kind, this is more aggressive. Depending on how your body is feeling, that's what you wanna go by. Today, I'm gonna go with a less aggressive one, and I would also recommend if you have a big one, those are great too, okay? All I'm gonna get you to do is just laying down, putting your head right on the foam roller. And all I'm gonna get you to do is just let your head go from one side to the other. Just releasing the tension, trying to feel the body as you're doing this nice slow movement. If you need to stop on one side for a little bit, please do so. I want you to really feel your muscles getting pushed into. So I'm going to get you to put it back to center, so your head center, looking straight up. Push slightly into your foam roller and then just let your right ear go down towards the foam roller. Still pushing into it nicely, just feeling a nice hold. Back to center, relax, push back in, over to the left side. Back to center. Now at your own speed, continue doing that a couple more times. Just releasing the tension in your neck here. If you're not using a foam roller, when you're using a ball, I don't want you to push directly on the spine, okay? I want you to put it onto the side of the neck and just push slightly onto it. Feel that nice relaxation. You can move your head a little bit forward and back, sideways, still feeling the ball should be right into your trap here. It should not be on the spine, okay? I don't want you to push directly onto your spinal cord. Just feeling a nice release. If you want to, you can bring your chin up slightly. Very important that you do not have pain, okay? So if you're pushing to the point that you're having pain, any kind of shooting pain, you're pushing too hard, release it. That doesn't mean you shouldn't have a little bit of tension, just no pain. Jess or any other instructor that is watching, if there is any problems with technology, can you please text me, because my comments are all gone. And thank you for recognizing that you are in my house right now. Other side. Nice deep breaths. And all we're going to do is start going down the back slightly, okay? So getting that tension out of the neck first. Now we're just going to go down a little bit into the traps, into the top of your back, okay? If you're using a ball, again, you would be using it right onto here, and you'd just be bringing it down, still not going on your spine, okay? Just bring yourself slightly up and just rotating back and forth. If you feel tension or a ball in there, if you can feel tighter muscles, spend a little bit of time on that, just rotating just on the top of the upper back. We're not going into your thoracic yet, okay? We're not going into the lumbar, we're just going into the top. If you're using the ball, use the one side, use the other side, then going back. If you're using a foam roller, please, at this point in time, don't go into your thoracic, so don't go into your middle back, okay? All I want you to do is just bring yourself right into where your scapula is, your shoulder blades, no farther down than the bottom of your shoulder blades or scapula. And I want you to try to round your back slightly and just go back and forth nice and slowly. Just going down one vertebrae at a time, nice and controlled movements, nice deep breathing. You want to still be breathing. If you're somewhere tight, it's like, whoa, it takes the breath out of me. Stop and relax on there for a second. Enjoy it. Let it release if it will. Just nice and controlled. No stress here. Just feeling your body, getting to know your body, making sure your body is stretching out. Nice and controlled, like a deep tissue massage that you don't have to pay for today, guys. Now relaxing your shoulder blades back, allow your head to just come back slightly. From there, bring your arms up, nice and up, and just allow it to go all the way to the bottom of your thoracic. And back up all the way to the top, to your C7. So the top of your neck. So you've got to make sure I can stay in. And you want to go to about the top of your shoulders, to about midline of your back, or a little bit farther down. Okay, we are moving down the back now slowly. So just rotating up and down it, nice and slow, nice and controlled. If you want to deepen it a little bit, I find when my arms are up, I feel more of a stretch. Some of you might find right in the middle that you almost feel like you can't breathe because you're so tight. People don't realize that the thoracic is a lot of the time the tightest part due to the fact that if you have lower back problems or upper back problems, it takes a lot of the burden, okay? So just up and down on your back. Nice and controlled, nice movements. Deep breaths, nice deep breath in, nice deep breath out. Enjoy it. Enjoy feeling the looseness. It's going to feel even better afterwards, I promise you this. Because realistically, when you're getting a deep tissue massage, a lot of the time, it really hurts. But afterwards, you're like, wow, that's great, okay? Nice and slowly, up and down, okay? So we're just going all the way up to the top again. And this time, all I want you to do is going all the way down, right into your lumbar, your lower back. I'm going to take off on you here, guys, sorry. And then all the way up again. So we're going all the way down now, okay? So all the way up. All the way down. From there, allow your shoulder blades to be planted on the ground. I keep on rotating, sorry. Let your shoulder blades be planted on the ground. Let your hips be up. Allow your legs to go straight down, feeling a nice stretch right in the front of the legs, core tight, and then release. So almost a pelvic tilt and just relax. I would recommend while you're doing this, you would be spending some time on each one of these movements, okay? Not rushing, just feeling what your body needs. If it needs more time, give it more time. If it starts going, oh my goodness, I can't handle that, move out of it. And then bring yourself back into it, okay? no pain. Pain, not good. Discomfort will be there in tighter spots. Bringing your knees up to your chest, allowing your hips to slightly go from one side to the other. Perfect. Feeling a nice stretch right through that lower back. Control. No pain. From there, allow your right leg down. Left leg, let it go over to the other side, just slightly, not to the ground. Most people will not be able to go to the ground. That's okay. Back to center, just feeling a nice stretch in the lower back again. And just slightly over. Just till you feel a nice stretch. Keywords, nice. Back to center. From here, planting both feet on the ground. Allow yourself to come up and just rotating on your gluteus maximus, your butt. Okay? Just rotating up and down. If you're feeling a little bit of tension there, then this is mainly if you've just did squats over the last couple days or deadlifts. Then you might feel it into your buttocks. From here, all I'm going to get you to do, and I'm going to change my angle just a little bit, just so you can see this at first, is bring one knee over top, nice and close as you can. If you have to bring it out more, that's fine too. Whatever your flexibility is, then allow yourself to put your hand on, and where the knee is where you want to push into the foam roller, right into the side of your butt, okay? Your gluteus medius. It could be tight. Into the hip, pushing down, feeling a nice controlled. If you can bring it down more, please do so. If you can go up onto more of your butt, that's good. And then down. Okay? Some people won't even realize that they're tight there. That's okay. That's what this is for, is to help you figure out where you need to work on your tightness, or find your tighter areas in your body. From there, going back to center, bringing that leg down, we're going to go to the other side. Anything you do on one side, I like to do on the other. Bringing the foot up, bringing it in, bring my knee, push my hip down, so moving my butt slightly, and just up and down on the side of your butt. If you're not feeling it enough, bring your foot in more, push your knee down a little bit more. I would not, just body pushing it down, not your actual hand. Let your body do this. Nice and controlled. If you find a sweet spot, don't be afraid to stay there. You can rotate in and out slightly, just releasing any knots that there is there. Nice and controlled, up and down. Perfect. If you're doing the ball, you can do the exact same movement with the ball on the side of the butt. You can bring your leg over, bring yourself up on it, and just back and forth. This is way more aggressive. I'm going to pre-warn you that. So if you need to put that leg back down just to rotate it onto the side there, then do so. Remember, you're reading your body. I'm not there to help you on this. So I need you to actually really concentrate on making sure your body is feeling it, and feeling it in a good way, not a painful way. A little bit of a discomfort. If you're tight somewhere, it can be very discomforting, but it should not be sharp shooting pains or any kind of pains, okay? Sorry guys, if you can hear kids in the background, I've got peeves here. The next one we're going to go into is our hamstrings. I actually prefer the ball for the hamstrings because it is more direct, okay? And then you just rotate it back and forth on the ground. Okay, back and forth on your hamstrings. If you are using a foam roller, you can put your whole body up on top of it and back down, pushing down on it as you can. If you're not feeling it very well, that's okay. From here, try to straighten your legs slightly and just hinge forwards. You'll feel that stretch right into the back of the legs. That's what we're after, okay? Nice and controlled. Now stopping back and forth. So you're actually swaying your legs back and forth. I'm more into the ball at this point. I like the ball for my hamstrings a lot. But right now, I'm just going to give you a hold. Okay. Nice and slow, nice and controlled. You're still just on those hamstrings. If you're going back and forth on them, or if you are up and down, whatever works better for you, spending some time on them. Okay. If you need to stabilize and just push into it, go ahead, okay? You can hold on to your foam roller at any time. Mainly if you feel like it's going to slip away on you, grab it. Don't worry about it. There's nobody there to judge you for number one. And number two, it happens all the time. So you shouldn't feel uncomfortable about it. Keywords, shouldn't. If you need a little more time on any of these, remember at the end, please do so. So really take note of each one of these movements and where you need to spend more time on. Next one we're going to go into is our calves, okay? So with our calves here, you can push your body right up on your arms and rotate up and down on them if you choose, or you can just push forward on them and going back and forth, okay? With the ball, again, that is way more aggressive. This is more aggressive due to the fact that it's got more area, or less area, surface area, and all your weight goes onto it. So this is more aggressive than this by quite a bit, I find. Some people's body reacts differently for sure, so I can't say all personnel. If you're using a ball, again, back and forth on those hammies, or no, sorry, on your calf muscles, so this, back and forth, up and down, on the side, really feel that. Then I want you to actually change your toe. So if you're using the foam roller, that is fine too. You could be using both if you wanted to, actually. You can plant your feet, bring your toes towards you, and then back and forth, okay? And then back and forth on each way, okay? Whatever works best for you, please do that. Then I want you to do, because I just want you to feel the different stretches, letting your toes point away from you, and then do the same movements there. Okay, back and forth, up and down. A lot of people don't realize how tight their calves can be. Okay, so you can make your toes point away. You can also make your toes point in, whichever is better for you. Okay, I want you to feel a nice stretch. Some of you are going to feel like a bump. Spend some time on that bump. Push into it. Feel a nice relaxation of it. Nice deep breathing. Don't stop breathing. Breathing is important. Very important. From there, what we're going to do is we're going to go to our shins. Number one question I've got for shins. Can you break your shins? Well, if you feel like you're going to break your shins while we're on them, number one, you're not going to. I do hope your bones are stronger than that. If they are not stronger than that, I'd recommend to go see a doctor, okay? It might be just your shins are a little bit more tight than you realize, okay? Plus also some people's bones are a little bit more sensitive than others. So what you're going to do is bring yourself up to sitting on your feet. You're going to bring one leg up and then the other leg up, stabilizing on it, up and down on your shins. Point your toes away, nice and controlled. Then try it the other way. Bring your toes down and just up and down. From there, you can try it with both ways, toes away, back and forth. Where you're actually going from one side of your shin to the other side of your shin. Okay? So from here, back and forth, Feeling a nice stretch. Stop anytime you need to and put more time into it. If you're using a ball, put one leg on the ground, the other one goes on top of the shin, and just up and down on it too, just the same. And even side to side. Recommendation, not right on the front on here. You want to be more on the meatier part. But listening to your body, most importantly. Okay, so if there's no pain, that's great. Okay, so just on the side and up and down, over. I don't like it directly where there's less muscle. And you could go to the other side with your ball if you're at that point. Okay, from here, we're going to go up into our quads. What we're going to do is put our quads onto the foam roller. If you're doing it with the ball, you're going to be doing the exact same thing, except just with one leg at a time. So you're going to bring yourself over, put your quads right on it. Bring your toes to your bum, up and down. Then try putting your legs straight, doing the same. Up and down. Just feeling both ways to see which one you can feel more aggressively. Again, bringing it up. That actually helps the quads to stretch. And then bringing it down. At any point in time, there is pain, make sure you stop. From there, get yourself to approximately mid-leg. Bring your legs up and then just let them go back and forth slightly. And then allow it to go all the way up, all the way down your legs. Not a race. If there's somewhere that's a little tighter and you want to spend a little bit more time on it, please do so, okay? Back and forth, up and down, just on your quads here. Again, making notes, if there's somewhere that is a little bit more tight, that you are going to spend more time on it right afterwards. I'd recommend doing it right after, otherwise we always say we're gonna do it later. And a lot of people don't. Some people are sad that they're going to watch this later. Perfect, okay? This is giving you a full body massage, okay? You can do this while watching TV. You can do this while playing with your kids. Just feeling a nice stretch. Okay, from there, all I'm going to get you to do is, this one's a little harder to show. Actually, before we do that one, we're going to do our IT bands. IT bands are typically very tight, okay, so there's the side of the leg. You can use your ball, or you can use your foam roller. Again, remember, the ball is a lot more aggressive, so if it hurts a lot, make sure you're ready to take your weight off at any time. From there, all I want you to do is putting it onto the side of the leg, rotating it up to your hip, and back down to right before your knee, okay? I put my one leg forward. You can do it back if some people like it that way better. Just up and down on the side. If you feel somewhere tight, push into it, enjoy it, try to help it release, and then rotate your body slightly forward and back, okay? Now, as we're doing that one, we're going to go up the leg, down the leg, there's a tight spot for me, back and forth. So, tight spot, don't be afraid to just push it a little bit, hold it for a second. You can keep going, keep going. If you can't, stop for a second. I'm feeling that one pretty good right this second. That's a lot tighter than I remembered it last. So I need to spend a little more time on that. You want your IT bands to be able to release a little bit. Anytime your IT bands become very, very tight, it will actually pull on your knees, okay? And that's not good for your knees. So we want to take care of our knees. We all want to be able to walk when we're 80, right? Some of us when we're 50. bringing it down, going to the other side. While you guys are getting ready on the other side to go down your IT bands, one side is always tighter than the other. Just so you know, this here is the ball, and we're gonna put it right underneath this leg. We're gonna bring it up and down, side to side. If you are there, that is great. I honestly think my IT bands might be a little tight for this one, so I won't be using that today, because I sure can feel that. So I'm going back to my soft foam roller and just going up and down on the side. Remember, you're just making a mental note right now where you need to work more at pushing forward, back. I'm going to put my foot back just so you can actually see. Forward, back, your weight going down the leg, nice and slow, no rush, okay? Nice and slow, forward, back. I'm a little tight there too, and I'm actually tight. It's a good thing to know. I'm going to spend more time on it. I promise you, I'm just like you. It's hard to do it when you're trying to do 300 other things. Nice and controlled. And then release. Remember, you can go back to that at any time, okay? From there, we're going to do our chest. This is a lot harder for me to explain when I'm not there, because usually I will actually help people get into the position so that they can feel it the best. But I'm going to try anyways. So this here, I want you to put it, I'm going to try to show you backwards, like that, across your back. So it's actually right below your scapula on the one side, and it comes up to your shoulder on the other side. Okay? So laying down, putting it slightly slanted. I'm going to do the other side first so that then I can show you. And then this is coming up to this side up here. The other one is going downwards. I'm going to rest my head on it. I'm going to take my hand and bring it all the way back to the ground. This is going to stretch out the pectoral muscle to your chest, okay? If you don't feel it, bringing it up a little bit more, or pushing your body slightly over a little bit more, and then relax. Some of you need to go less. That's okay. So you're less up. I'm going to show you the other side just so you can see. So per se, if this is on your back like this, okay, your arm is up and it's just wrapped around it, stretching out the pectoral muscle, okay, your chest. Nice deep breaths, relaxing, and we're going to go to the other side in a few minutes here. I'm just rushing because I feel like I can't see you guys, and I'm like, so the head rest, arm open is on this side. So if my head is on the right side, if my foam roller is on the right side, my left arm will go back out, stretching the whole pectoral muscle. And release, going to the other side. Just making sure that I'm not getting, hoping everybody's seeing this. I don't need that right now. That is Jess texting me, but it's not about this, I don't think. So we're going to the other side. We've already stretched out our left arm. We're going to go to our right arm now. Okay, going back. So opposite side. And then allowing the foam roller, it's actually my right ear's here. It is going down like this, under my scapula, and allowing my arm to come over. Just feeling a nice stretch right into the pectoral muscles.
Right into the rotator cuff. To rotate it out and again, up you can go, or you can even swipe it around. Again, listening to your body, making sure that you're feeling a nice stretch is the most important thing, okay? From here, we're gonna go right into our delts.
What I need you to do is put the foam roller sideways. You can also do this with your ball. Recommendation, if you're going to do your pectoral muscles with your ball, do it on the wall, okay? Because that way then you can still open up, but you're not putting as much weight on, because that's very aggressive right into your back, pushing into your back, and still trying to stretch out the pectoral muscle, you lose a little bit of control. This one here, all you're gonna do is put your shoulder right into, and then back and forth right against your delts, okay? The muscles that are right on the top of your shoulder, delt muscles. Or not right on top of the shoulders, silly. Right on top of the arm, sort of, right. Not the king of the castle. And back and forth, up and down. Feel a tight spot, don't be afraid to spend some time on it. And then allow yourself to go up and down on the side of your arm. Okay? Again, if you have any previous shoulder injuries, this is very good for you to spend some time here. It's very hard to spend time by yourself. That's why you play music, relaxing music, listening to just that. Try to focus on your body. Don't focus on everything else that's going on in life right now. From there, we're going to put our elbow on it, and we're just going to rotate up and down on the side of it, or on the bottom of it, stretching out our triceps, okay? Push as much weight as you want into it, making sure there's no pain. If you push down a little bit, you're actually helping stretch out the triceps muscles a little bit. Don't be afraid to rotate back and forth a little bit. Palm out and just allow it to wrap right up the side of your body. Okay? So right there, side of the body. Up, then back down. Okay? If you feel a sweet spot, somewhere that hurts, enjoy it. That's how you get feeling better. Breathe through it. Enjoy the moment. When you're ready to go again, go back up and down. If you feel a place again that has a little bit of resistance, relax on it. Enjoy it. And back up. Going to the other side, going right back to the delts, so putting your shoulder right into the side of your foam roller. You can do this with a ball too, remember it's more aggressive, but if you're doing it with the ball, you can do that too, and just back and forth on the ball. The bright yellow is easier for you guys to see, I'm assuming, so I'm going to go back to the yellow, but you can use your ball for the same movements. Back and forth. Feeling every push into it. If you're not feeling it good enough, you want it deeper, push harder down. Put more of your weight in. If you don't, then release it. Okay? Keep breathing. Enjoy it. Getting to know where you need to more, spend more time. Some places
You probably didn't even realize you need to spend more time. So important. From here, putting your elbow on it, just allowing it to go and stretch up the tricep, up and down on the back of your arm, stopping when you need to, allowing your arm to go back and forth a little bit, right across the back of your arm. Okay? Sorry, guys. I don't think my place is the most relaxing place. Nice and controlled. And then from here, you can bring it down a little bit more into your armpit area. And then just up on the side of your body, back down. Okay? I'm taking off again, realizing I keep on going that way. That's normal, but not so good when you have a camera on you. And back and up and down, right up the side, feeling control, anywhere tight, spend some time on there. Nice deep breathing. You can even stretch out your neck while you're doing this. Whatever feels good, moving forward and back. My lats are a little tight, okay? So control. Being able to push as much as you want or to release a lot, depending on what you need, okay? From there, I would recommend you doing it again. Starting at the front point where you're just relaxing on your back. Nice deep breaths. Let your head go back and forth. This time while you're going through the routine, I would recommend that you spend more time on each one of the movements. So I'd say play the video back again. When you get to an exercise, play it and then pause it. I would recommend you at least do a minute on each individual area. And places that you're tighter on, spend more time on. Make sure you drink a lot of water after this. If you have any injuries that you maybe didn't realize you had, please make sure you fill out a CF98. This is Trina in Wainwright. I hope you guys have a great day. It is Wednesday, so it's the middle of the week, hump day, right? So I hope you guys have a continuous great week like I'm having. So enjoy yourself. I am going to try to get a hold of all of you that are emailing me slowly but surely. I hope you can go through this routine again and enjoy it. One movement at a time. Listen to your body. Spend more time on it. Have a great day. Be safe. God bless. Bye.